أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يا رب العالمين, to accept, inshallah, your steps to the house of Allah. And inshallah, this is a great reward from Allah, ثواب, big ثواب, when you come to the masjid, you attend this halaqa, especially when we talk about the Quran, the Holy Quran. It is the best. Why Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whosoever sits in the masjid, learning the book of Allah, reciting the book of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shower them with his mercy, tranquility, forgiveness, and you go home while your sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make a replacement for it, exchange it to good deeds for you. And Malaika, they are asking forgiveness for you while you are sitting until the salah is coming, inshallah. Tonight we are in episode number 4 in Surah Taha. We start from verse 36. قال قد أوتيت سؤلك يا موسى. موسى عليه السلام, Prophet Moses, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for 8 things. What did he ask Allah for? رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من أهلي هارون أخي أشدد به أزري وأشركه في أمري كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا. I want to cover كثير. 8 things he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. And then later again I tell you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him, Allah Almighty, he gives him these 8 things I explained it last time. And he will add 8 free. Without questioning, Allah will give him another 8 things. Subhanallah. Or others, you know, 8 other things. He said, Allah replied to Musa, you have been granted with what you requested, O Musa. You asked me for these 8 things, I give you. Expand your chest. I make your task easy. I release the knot from your tongue. And I send your brother Aaron as a helper for you. And he will strengthen you. And also, كَانُ سَبَّحَكَ كَثِيرًا. And this is what he said, I want to glorify you more. And to spread your da'wah, your rasala, your message. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending another 8 blessings or things free to Musa alayhi salam. The blessings of Allah upon Moses before even his prophethood. What did he say? وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى. Moses, we give you whatever you ask, before you ask. And we give you whatever you ask, and we give you without questioning. And we give you even before you did speak. You don't know how to speak, we give you. Didn't Allah save Musa from Pharaoh when he was infant baby? Did he ask Allah for anything? He was just a little baby. And Allah gives him. And he said, وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى. Allah replied to Musa alayhi salam, and we had bestowed our favor on you another time. Another time. طيب, what's is it mananna? What is the minna? Al minna means al ata, when Allah bestow somebody something. And al minna is different from the reward. I work for Qasim Bhai for a certain job. He said, Sheikh, this is your wage because you did work. But the minna in Arabic means you give without return. That's why I said Allah bestowed him. Huh? Allah is giving you. Huh? It's called wahabna, hiba, ata, minna. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted us by Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah gifted المؤمنين Rasulullah. He's a gift for us. عليه الصلاة والسلام. And المنّة giving without return. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. He said, مرة أخرى, when he was little, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to his mother how to save Musa. إذ أوحينا, when that happened, إذ أوحينا إلى أمك ما يوحى. When we inspired to your mother an important revelation. What is the important revelation? The only one he knows its importance is Allah Azza wa Jal. What is the revelation? Allah did not send Jibreel to the mother of Musa. She was not a prophet. Allah inspired her. It's called Wahy al-Ilham. وحي إلهامي. Allah inspired, Allah also inspired the bees. سبحانه وتعالى said, وأوحينا إلى النحل أن اتخذي من الجبال بيوتا ومن الشجر ومما يعرشون. الله inspired the bees. You know the bees? Honey? سبحان الله. Yeah. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, وأوحى إلى السماء. Allah سبحانه وتعالى inspired the heaven. Allah سبحانه وتعالى inspired the earth. إذا زلزلت الأرض وأخرجت الأرض وقال الإنسان ما له. يومئذ تحدث أخبرها بأن ربك أوحى لها. See? الله سبحانه وتعالى will inspire the earth to split the judgment of scum. خلاص. Order. فسي. فالله سبحانه وتعالى the inspiration of the prophets through Jibreel is different when Allah inspired the animals or insects or the earth or the sky or even human, but they are not prophet like the mother of Musa عليه السلام. الله سبحانه وتعالى said when Allah saved Fir'aun, I'm sorry, ملعون فرعون, saved Moses from فرعون. When Allah saved Moses from Pharaoh, while he used to kill the boys, he told his mom, if you scare, you are afraid of him, just فألقيه في اليم ولا تخاف ولا تحزني. Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, أهوت إلى ما يوحى أن اقذفيه في التابوت فاقذفيه في اليم فليلقيه اليم بالساحل. These are the eight things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving it to Musa. While he did not ask Allah for this because he was little baby, infant. How he gonna ask? Yeah. When he grow up, he came back from Jordan, going to Fir'aun, said, Rabbi, shrah li sadri. He asked Allah because he was a man above 40. But now he's infant baby. Fir'aun is killing the boys. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanna save Musa. And Allah inspired his mom what to do. And اقذفيه في التابوت. Number one. فاقذفيه في اليم. فليلقيه اليم بالساحل. يأخذه عدو لي وعدو له. وألقيت عليك محبة مني ولا تصنع على عيني. إذ تمشي أختك فتقول. يعني eight things Allah عز وجل bestowed on Musa without even he did not ask Allah for that. It was infant baby. طيب. He said to place you, O Moses, in a chest cradle. And cast it into the Nile River. Then the river stream will carry it by the shower, the bank, and the person who will pick him up or pick the box or the chest cradle out of the river is an enemy to me and to him, which is Pharaoh. Yes. And I had cast love. I have cast love. On you from myself, Allah is talking to Musa, and that you were brought up before my eyes and under my protection. Look at this ayah, verse number 39. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, your mom, she's making the box where the tabut, where you're gonna, she's gonna put you into that box and she's gonna cast that box like this into the Nile River, the water. And the stream of the water will carry him to the tunnels. And subhanAllah, how that box, he did not know which tunnel. Allah guided the box to go to the specific tunnel to take him to the palace of Pharaoh. See? It's a work of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, otherwise the Nile River is big. We'll go with the stream all over, maybe we don't know where. But there are too many tunnels is going to the palace of Pharaoh from the Nile River. The specific tunnel, the box, being carried Musa to go to the Pharaoh palace, subhanAllah. By the work of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanna protect him. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told his mom, cast him to the Red River. Don't worry. لا تخافي ولا تحزني. Don't scare. Don't be sad. We'll take care of him. He's under my protection, under my eyes. Allah is telling and inspired the mother of Musa. If you tell any lady or any woman, just because you're scared from your son and he's gonna be killed, just put him in a box and throw him in the river. She's gonna say, are you crazy? I will not do that. I'm gonna put him between my arms. Let me die with him. I will never gonna do that. But the mother of Musa, when Allah inspired her, she was a very strong mu'mina, a good lady. That's why she trusted Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She was very confident when she did that Allah azza wa jalla will save her son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he inspired her, I will bring him back to you. Trust me, not just that. What else? And I will make him a messenger. وجعلوه من المرسلين. إنا ردوه إليك will bring him back to you وجاعلوه من المرسلين and I will make him a messenger too. What means he gonna be a man one day? Allah سبحانه وتعالى told her that. But when that happened practically, when she started doing what Allah is telling her, it was very fast, one after another like this. Because when you make something, maybe Pharaoh will discover that he's gonna kill her and he's gonna burn her family. فالله سبحانه وتعالى look said أن اقذفيه في التابوت just cast him, put him into the box, التابوت. They call it the chest cradle, put him inside. فا look at the فا in the آية فا فاقذفيه just put him into it inside. Lock it. فليلقه اليم and cast him into another river and فليلقه اليم على طول immediately the stream of the water will carry him very fast to the Pharaoh palace. سبحان الله. This is the work of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Everything goes very fast. فهنا we have three إلقاءات through when the cast of, this, of things you throw it. Number one, Allah سبحانه وتعالى throw the love, kindness, tranquility into the chest of the mother of Musa and also inside that box for Musa. Now, he was not crying or scaring or anything. Just baby sleeping, enjoying the cradle. They call it chest cradle. Like just mom, his mom carrying him. He never cried. And subhan number two, a taboot that the box, just throw it into the, don't just put him like this while you're crying. Just throw it like this and leave. Don't worry. We'll take care of him. فَلْيُلْقِهِ يُلْقِهِ when you throw something like far away. Just do your son like this with the box. Don't worry. Don't hesitate. Allah is giving you order. This number two. Number three, and subhanAllah, the yam itself, the stream of the water of the Nile River itself, was throwing Musa to the palace of Pharaoh. SubhanAllah, see, it's order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aywa. يَأْخُذْهُ عَدُوٌ لِي وَعَدُوٌ لِي. Pharaoh is my enemy because he claimed that he's God. He's not God. He's not a God. And he's the enemy of Musa too because Musa gonna stand against him in the future. And instead of that love, Allah, Pharaoh used to love Musa when he was little. That's why he grew up in his palace. He used to love him too. But it's fake love because when he stood against him, stood up against him, that love became enmity. For that's why, subhanAllah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to learn from this ayah. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is willing to do something, Allah Azza wa Jalla will do it, even through his enemy. Who was taking care of Pharaoh, of Musa, and being for his breastfeed? Pharaoh himself. And the ayat is coming right now. Who was taking care of Musa? I grew up in his belly. Pharaoh, the one he was about to kill him, and he was killing the little boys of Bani Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Pharaoh is the enemy of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do his will through Pharaoh, his enemy. And he was stupid. He did not know. Subhanallah. Yeah. سبهم لا يشعرون. Allah said in the Quran, وهم لا did not know. And the wife of Pharaoh, she loved Musa so much. What she did when she saw him inside the box and when they get him out of the water. قرة عين لي ولك. This is the coolness of my eye. This is the coolness of what? Of my eye, قرت عين لي ولك. سبحان الله. And don't kill him. Might be will benefit us or the future, or we can adopt him as a son. And Pharaoh, وهم لا يشعرون. Why they did not know? The Surah Al-Qasas, verse number 9. And Pharaoh was listening. He listened to his wife, and he did. فسبحان الله. Pharaoh, one time when Musa came to him, when he grew up and he said, I'm a messenger of Allah to you. He said, أَلَمْ نُرَبِّكَ فِينَا وَلِيدَ وَكُنْتَ وَلَبِثْتَ فِينَا مِنْ عُمُرِكَ سِنِينَ. Man, I am the one who grew you up. He was a little baby. I am the one who feed you and I make you a man. Pharaoh was telling him that. And you stayed with us too many years. What's wrong with you? From where you get this message and what you're talking about? أَلَمْ نُرَبِّكَ فِينَا وَلِيدَ. Like, for example, if you give someone favor, you do favor for someone, and you give him some money, whatever, you make anything good for him, and you get mad at him one time and say, hey, I'm the one who's feeding you. Remember, I gave you this and this and this and this. This is what he did to Musa عليه السلام. ألم نربك فينا وليدا؟ You just a little baby. You grew up in my palace. Who are you? Well, you're nothing. Fir'aun was telling him that. And we say the last years, this is what Fir'aun was telling him. فالله سبحانه وتعالى loves موسى. And he said, وألقيت عليك محبة مني ولتصنع على عيني. He said, and that you were brought up before my eyes and under my protection, and I had cast love on you from myself. Allah loves Musa عليه السلام and protected him, and he grew up under his eye. One time, while Musa was little boy, say maybe like 4 years, 5 years, one time while Fir'aun was sitting in his chair, he was claiming himself as God. Musa was jumping above his chest and was hitting him, and he get his beard and start hitting him like this. And start hitting him, and he was grabbing him from his beard like that. And Fir'aun said, hey, take this boy and kill him. Like this. Kill him. And the wife of Fir'aun, he said, no, my husband, majesty, listen. He's a little boy. He did not know the jamra from the tamra. What is the jamra from the tamra? The tamra, the date, it's called tamr, tamra. One is tamra. And what is the jamra? The same size of the date, if you burn some metals or something and you put it above the fire. It's called jamra, jamra min al-nar in your hand. And he said, no, look what he did to me. And she said, I have a good idea. He was about to kill him. Serious. He's a king. He said, I'm your God. He get the guards, kill him. He said, no. I don't know the jamra from the tamra, man. Listen, he's a little boy. The Asia, she loves Musa so much. And he said, let's examine him. Put jamra, fire, and the same size, same shape, the tamra date, and see which one he's going to pick it up. If he take the date, means he knows. If he took the fire and he put it above his tongue, means he don't know nothing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala moved his hand to take the fire and to put it above his knot. Eat it, ya Musa, eat it. And he take it to eat it, and he found that it's a fire. And they said, no, he doesn't know nothing, leave him, leave him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. So that's why he said, وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي. You've been under, you grow up under my eyes and I had my protection too. I protected you too many times, ya Musa. Fir'aun was about to kill you when he was little. And I moved your hand from the date to eat the fire, to put it above your tongue. That's why he said, oh Allah, help me to take this knot from my tongue. Because of that, when he grew up, it was difficult for him to speak. He was not speaking easy like what we talk. That's why he said, وَحْلُ الْعُقْدَةَ مِنْ لِسَانِ يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. Take it away from your tongue. I want to deliver the message. See, subhanAllah, this is exactly what happened to Musa alayhi salam. What else? Verse number 40. إِذْ تَمْشِي أُخْتُكَ فَتَقُولُ هَلْ أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَنْ يَكْفُلُهُ فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ. Look what Allah is giving him. فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ كَيْ تَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنْ وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَمِّ وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونًا فلبثت سنين في أهل مدين ثم جئت على قدر يا موسى. Look this ayah, verse 40, is showing us how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really was the only one watchful over the steps of Musa when he was there, subhanAllah. When Fir'aun and the Asiya, they received the box and they get Musa, they started getting for him women to breastfeed him. Women to breastfeed him. فعافهم. He started crying, I don't want to touch any one of these women. I don't want to take any milk from anyone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stopped him. And the mother of Musa was telling his sister, they said, Allah alam, her name is Maryam, whatever. Listen, go follow the steps of this box to see what is the box. And the sister of Musa, a young girl, she was looking at the box step by step, and she found it where it's going to the palace of Fir'aun. She was around the area. Every day that little boy crying, he doesn't want to suck the milk from any woman at all. And she came to one of the servants. She told them, I know a lady, she can breastfeed him. She meant her mom. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where is that lady? She's from Bani Israel. They did not know that is the mother of Musa. And subhanAllah, he came back to his mom, stayed with her at home, Fir'aun paying for his milk, for his food. SubhanAllah, see, how is Allah's work? If Allah wanna do it even through your enemy gonna help you. That's subhanAllah. Look at this ayat. And we bestowed another favor on you when your sister walked along the river bank, following the chest, below the box. And she said to those who picked you up, shall I guide you to a woman who can nurse the baby and her eyes might comfort? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that. Aywa, he can nurse the baby. In this way, we return you back to your mother, Ya Musa, O Musa. So, shall we not grieve and her eyes might comfort? And when you killed the Coptic person when he grew up, and you were afraid of that act because people, they want to kill him. He was afraid and escaped. Huh? What happened? And you were in anguish because of that. We delivered you from that and purified you. And then you went to Midian, which is Jordan, and stayed with the people there for years, 10 years, and as a shepherd. And after all of this, you came, O Moses, to a distant point of time, which is the distant point of time, which is after 10 years, you came back to Egypt. I appointed this time for you. Why? In the law of Pharaoh, if somebody make a crime and he kill someone like Musa, he did, if he stayed 10 years outside the country or far away, nobody catch him, خلاص, it will be dismissed. This is the distant appointed time for Musa. خلاص, your case is dismissed, you are Pharaoh, go back. This is the law of Pharaoh system. SubhanAllah. Like the system nowadays. If you have any, in Egypt until now, if you have any case in the court and you're not showing and somehow they did not catch you, after 3 years, don't worry about it. Yeah, خلاص. But not killing, something else. Yeah, after 3 years, it's dismissed already. خلاص, done from the court, you know. So anyway, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was watching and he was taking care of Musa alayhi salam. The mother said to his sister, Surah Al-Qasas, verse 11, وَقَالَتْ لِأُخْتِهِ قُصِّيهِ تَتَبَّعِيهِ Follow his, him, walk behind him and see where is the, your brother is going. فَبَصُرَتْ بِهِ عَنْ جُنُوبٍ وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ As I told you, subhanAllah. فَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى returning him back to his mother. He went after killing that Coptic man. He did not mean to kill him. That man, Yahudi guy, he was a troublemaker from Bani Israel. And that Coptic man was fighting with him. Coptic Egyptian, Yahudi from Bani Israel, they were in slavery for Pharaoh, slaves. And that man from the family of Pharaoh, he's a big guy. And that man, he punished the Yahudi, the Israeli. And Israeli is like Musa, he's Israeli from Bani Israel. He was standing to fight for the Israeli guy. And subhanAllah, what happened is, Musa alayhi salam, well, he get nervous all the time. He was very strong. He just booked him. He booked the Egyptian man, the Coptic man, like this. Hey, man, stop. Like, just he did like this, the man died. He killed him. And subhanAllah. And second day, the Israeli guy, he started telling everybody, Musa, he's the one who killed the guy. Well, he was defending him, kharban. Yes. And they said, the Musa, he said, why are you telling me, Abel? Why are you telling me? You put me in trouble with Pharaoh. He said, hey, Moses, are you going to kill me like the way you killed the man yesterday? And pious man, he said, Musa, listen, I love you so much. Get out of the Medina city because they are looking for you now. If they catch you, they're going to kill you right now. And Sayyidina Musa, he escaped to Jordan. Where is Jordan? Madian, far away. Distance, subhanAllah. No airplane, no bus, no ship, nothing. Sayyidina Musa, Allah gave him power and he was escaping. Hungry, afraid. There are too many stories in between, but I'm just giving you the how he reached to Midian. He found these two beautiful young girls, shepherd. They provide water for their sheep, and this because their father. They said his prophet Shu'aib, Allahu A'lam. But he's grave in the area. Been there too many times. Brother Ahmed was there this year. Yes, imagine that Sayyidina Musa, he was in this area 14 years, and this area, by the way. You cannot breathe there. تحت سطح البحر. under the level surface of ocean. يعني cannot breathe normally there. I've been in this area. رضا أحمد was there last year. And سبحان الله, more you go under down mountains, you cannot breathe. سبحان الله, very low. That's why Allah said in the Surah Al-Rum and the Quran, في أدنى الأرض. أدنى الأرض, the lowest of the earth were in Jordan. This أدنى الأرض. That's why it was the battle between the Roman and the Persian there. And Allah said in Surah Al-Rum, غلبت الروم. Allah mentioned that. أدنى الأرض, Jordan. And they are claiming there is no water in Jordan now because our cousins, they take everything from Tabaria and they did not leave anything for Jordanian. While Jordan area full of gas, full of oil, full of water. But nobody from Jordanian allowed to dig a well there. I've been there 10 years and I know the law. See, if they catch him digging well, they take him to jail direct. Yes, that area full of gas, oil, water. Allah said, Adna al-Ard, the lowest on earth. And everything is going under the ground to the lowest of the earth. There everything, but rules, يا باشا. احنا ما عندناش حاجة. احنا don't have nothing actually in our countries. Our country has been sold a long time ago. يعني والله المستعان. I don't want to talk more. خلينا في قصة سيدنا موسى. Let's go back to موسى عليه السلام. المهم, سيدنا موسى, he found these two girls. People, they put that big rock above the well. They were not able to carry that rock to provide water for their sheep. And سيدنا موسى, he saw them. Without questioning them, just he was carrying the rock himself. Allah gives him the power of 60 men. He was carrying the rock like this himself while he was afraid, scaring, tired, hungry, everything. And after he finished, he did not even look at the girls. They went to home with the sheep after he watered them. He sat under one of the trees there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, ثُمَّ تَوَلَّى إِلَى الظِّلْ. He sat under the shade. فقال, and he started raising his hand to Allah. فقال رب إني لما أنزلت إلي من خير فقير. Oh Allah, I'm poor, I'm مسكين. I have no shelter, I escaped from Fir'aun, I'm hungry, I have nobody. Immediately, immediate answer, Allah immediately answered his du'as. He sent one of these girls and she said, فجاءته إحدهما تمشي على استحياء, very shy. I think he married her and he get a boy from her. My dad is asking for you. Come, please. He want to give you the reward because the wage because you helped us. Long story short, he went there. He told him the story of Fir'aun. And he said, man, listen, I hire you to work for me 8 years. And if you make it 10, this is from your generosity, Moses. He said, خلاص 10. Later, subhanAllah, he married. Allah gave him the wife. Allah gave him the job. 14 years contract. Allah gives him what else? The wife, the job, the shelter, protection. Why? Because he was a good man. He helped someone without question. He helped these two girls. He did not know nothing. See, do khair, do good, and ask Allah. Allah will give you a lot. Don't worry. We learn from the Quran, too many stories. Anyway, subhanAllah, this is the story of Musa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَ وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا and you killed someone. فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَامِ your anguish. We saved you and purified your chest. He said, وَفَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَ what's mean فَتَنَّاكَ فُتُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts Moses alayhi salam into many afflictions, troubles, temptations, too many things. And they said, وَنَجَّيْنَاكَ and Allah saved him from all of that. Anyway, he stayed 10 years with the people of Madian, working as a shepherd. And he by the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah said, ثُمَّ جِئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدْرٍ يَا مُوسَىٰ and you come back to Egypt. Musa alayhi salam or Moses to a distant point of time you come back to Egypt to deliver my message. I give you the prophethood in the way subhanAllah to deliver the message to Pharaoh. And they said وَاصْطَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي last ayah and I bestowed my blessings on you to perfect you and choose you to myself to go for that order and the mission which is to go to Pharaoh and to tell him, Ya Kharban, Afendi, you're not a god, you're nothing. Just free Bani Israel. I don't need nothing from you. You want to claim your god? Claim your god. I am a messenger of Allah. I'm coming to you for one reason. Just free Bani Israel from the slavery. That's it. This is my mission. And Pharaoh, Taban, he was stupid. He did not listen to him. And the challenge comes there. And the point, Musa alayhi salam, he asked Allah for 8 things. And Allah said, Musa, you asked Allah, you asked me for 8 things. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي واجعل لي وزيرا من اهلي هارون اخي اجد بي ازر واشك في امري كانوا يسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا انك كنت بنا بصيرا When you became after 40 and I asked you, I give you order to go to Pharaoh, you asked me for 8 things which is I recited now. Remember that I give you 8 things without even questioning me when you was little infant baby. I saved you and this ayat I explained it tonight. Inshallah, we'll continue tomorrow. Jazakum Allah khair. Ayyakum, inshallah.